have made it to Montana. We're here. It's about 4 o'clock on Friday. Gonna go ahead and get everything unloaded, unpacked, organized, and everything like that. Rob's out right now, doing some glassing and stuff. We saw a bunch of deer on the way here. I noticed a particular pattern about where they were at, so that's a good thing, at least for the evening. So I think we might go out in the morning, maybe go where Rob's been, stick there for a bit, and then maybe go do some wandering, do some driving around, and see if we can find it and check out a couple spots. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and get unloaded and get ready to go in the morning. We were hoping to get here with some time to glass and drive around tonight, but I think we're probably just gonna stick with getting things organized and unpacked and stuff, and start off fresh in the morning. So Montana baby, here we go. First spot we're gonna go into. Saw a bunch of deer driving in, so we've got a few other spots marked, but we wanted to check this spot out first, so we're gonna grab our stuff and head in and see if we can find some deer. So this is a spot we kind of wanted to check off the list from the start, so go in here and see if we can find anything. It's first morning, so
good morning, and away we go.
Through there, and then Rob and I hiked up this ridge a ways, and he's down the ridge looking off that way, and then I'm sitting here just gonna sit and kind of glass these valleys for a while today, till probably about midday or so, and then we gotta head back, move one of the hotel rooms, and then go and glass some wheat fields and some hay fields and stuff, and see if we can't find some deer coming out in the evening, see where they came from, and move in on them in the morning. But for now, we're just going to kind of glass these valleys and see if we can't locate any deer this morning. So,
all right, well, we didn't see any deer, saw a lot of people in that first spot we went into this morning, so we sat till about midday and then packed up and got out of there, and now we had to go get a ORV sticker for the side-by-side, which turns out you can just do online. So we did that, and then switched over to Rob's truck, and we're gonna go do a little drive and a little scout and check out a couple spots of state and BLM kind of southeast of where we were at. So we did find some deer kind of in the same spots on the way out as we went into that other spot, so we might hunt there in the morning, but we're gonna check these spots out too and see if we can find a couple areas that look like they're worth going into. So
that's a really nice buck.
Yeah,
that one up there too looks big.
That's a nice buck.
Nice, but this one right here,
no, way up to your right.
All right, here we are, it's second day. It's Sunday, November 19th, second day in Montana. The first couple spots that we're gonna go to, the already had trucks in them this morning, even though we got out there pretty early. So we know if we wanna go back to those spots, we gotta get there early. This spot, we saw a couple deer both times driving past it yesterday, so drove down a little ways further and came parked up in here and walked up in. So my dad's kind of at the beginning of this ridge. Rob's about halfway, and then I came back in farther. We're just set up glassing basically. You can see there's all these little coulees behind me. They lead up to the ag fields down below on private. So basically what we're doing is hoping that as it gets warm, these deer are going to filter up out of those winter wheat and hay fields and alfalfa up through these coulees and up in here to bed for the day. So there's probably about 10 deer out in the field down at the bottom of this hill right now that we're watching. So hopefully they make their way up in here eventually. We did have one, like right when we first got in here, right at shooting light. All right, well, it's about noon right now. We did see a few deer, some across the street, and then we did have a couple come in here, but one was before daylight, and then the second one came in, and as soon as it came in, somebody came off the road after it. So starting to try and put together a better plan. I think that, you know, this area that we're in right here, I think is pretty good. But I think we need to go farther back, and I'm starting to understand what people say when they talk about this unit in this area. It's, you know, they say that you can find deer and you can have good deer hunting, but you got to get off the road. Alright, well, we got out side by side, decided to drive way back in here, so we drove back on this chunk of BLM about as far back as we could go. We're gonna walk up this hill a little further, see what's on the other side, maybe do some glassing, so here we go. Alright, well, we made it out here to that spot we were in last night. Dad and I are gonna hike up to the top where Rob and I saw this deer last night. So it is very windy today, like super windy. So
it's a twister. It's a
twister. And it's probably gonna be windier up there at the top. So could be a chilly day, but looking forward to it.
Let's have some fun.
in mind because I'm like, dude, we just like dealt with your gun.
Flat spot where it goes out around this knob, that's all public. Very.
Just gonna come this way. Yep. You see him? He's standing just to the left of those trees. He's walking to the left. I can't see. He's coming towards us. He's coming down in. He's coming right at us. Going right. Down the ridge. See him? Alright. You're gonna blast him this time. Just relax. You'll have an easy shot. He's close. Just take your time. Yep.
He's down.
Is he down?
I see him back.
Can you really?
I'm pretty sure he's down.
Oh, hold on.
Yeah.
I mean, I know. I saw where he went in. But he looked like he was running pretty good.
I was pretty sure I hit him the third time. Or the second time.
Or the fifth or the sixth. That's right where I saw him running.
That's where it looks like he's laying. I can see his antlers.
He was running pretty good.
He flinched. That one shot, that third shot. After that, he missed the piston. He just went way down. I didn't see him.
One of those shots at least in him, and we think he's laying down over there, so Rob's gonna keep his binoculars on him. I'm gonna get the spotting scope out. He definitely went down in there and laid down. We're just not sure if he's dead or if he's just laying in there, so we're gonna get the spotter out and see if we can get a better look at him.
Who's that?
those couple pine trees right by that super dead one, right?
Keep eyes on it. Rob's gonna work his way down in there and see if he can see him. I really hope he's laying down in there dead. Oh. He's a nice buck, dude. He's a nice buck. Got him.
Oh, was it? Did it really?
I saw a white. When I laid down, I could see that white. And that's what I saw was a white horse. And I knew that's what it was.
That sucks. I shot that off. I hit or something with a damn bullet. He's no monster, but...
That's a nice buck, though, man.
It
and
is.
We worked
it's better
freaking
than the first one.
Hard to get back in here and get him.
Yep. A little far back.
He's dead.
I gotta have this gun in there because this is the gun he really wanted to.
Yeah, man, you might have shot dead antler because that.
I think I did.
It just broke.
I think I did. Well, so let me ask you this, because I don't even think I've ever even watched this sort of thing before.
Mm-hmm.
So, do you normally, would you cut it out anyway?
No.
You still got to get the tenderloin.
So what you can do is you can reach in. So It's called the gutless method. Okay. You don't even open the cavity up.
Yeah.
You can, after you do the back straps, you can reach in and just pull them right out.
Okay.
It's actually kind of cool.
Steve,
my dad's buddy who hunts whitetails in South Dakota, but they end up packing them out a lot. The last two deer he shot in Indiana, he showed us how to do it.
Cool. Thank you very much for checking out our video. If you like what you see, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and click the notifications bell. That way you can get notifications every time we post new content. And if you haven't already, make sure to check us out on Facebook, Instagram, and you can check out our website at www.vitalshotproductions.com.